मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट शिव कृष्ण फ्रम द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग ईबीएस इंस्टिट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी कावली टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन डिजाइन ऑफ पावर स्प्रिंग दिस इज अ कंटिन्यूएशन टॉपिक ऑफ माय यूनिट 2 सो पावर स्क्रूज सो लास्ट क्लास वी कैन डिस्कस अबाउट द लीफ स्प्रिंग्स इंट्रोडक्शन टू लीफ स्प्रिंग्स कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ लीफ स्प्रिंग्स लेंथ ऑफ लीफ स्प्रिंग्स लीव्स standard size of automobile suspension springs, materials for leaf springs, and finally problems of leaf springs. So today I am going to presentation on continuing the topic from the unit 2. So this is power screws. The introduction. The power screws, also known as translation screws, are used to convert rotary motion into translatory motion. So the another name of the power screws is translation screws. So this will be used to convert rotary motion to translatory motion. For example, for the translatory power screws, in the case of the lead screws of the lathe, the rotary motion is available, but the tool has to be advanced in the direction of the cut against the cutting resistance of the material. In case of screw jack, a small force applied on the horizontal plane is used to raise or lower the large load. Power screws are also used in VCs, testing machines, presses, etc. In most of the power screws, the nut has axial motion against the resisting axial force while the screw rotates in its bearing. So the most of the power cases is used for the axial motion. Resisting the axial force in the screw is its bearing is used. In some screws, the screw rotates and moves axially against the resisting force, while the nut is satisfied and is others the nut rotates while the screw moves axially with no rotation. Next, types of screw threads used for power screws. So the following are the three types of power screws mostly used in the power screws. So it has three types used in the power screws. So what are they? The first one is a square thread. So next, second one is HCME or trapezoidal thread. So third one is buttress thread. So these are the three types of power screws used in the power screws. So we can discuss it one by one. The first one is a square thread. A square thread, as shown in the figure here, is adapted for the transmission of the power in each direction, in either direction. This thread results in maximum efficiency and minimum radial or bursting pressure on the nut. It is difficult to cut with the tapes and dies. It is usually cut on a lathe with a single point tool, and it cannot be easily compensated for wear. The screw threads are employed in screw jack, presses, and clamping devices. The standard dimensions for a screw thread, according to Indian standard, 4694 to 968. So the standard dimensions are, you can see the Jaladun data book. So like a table form is given. So the standard dimensions of the screw thread dimensions will be given in the data book. You can also see the data book. One tabular column is given the data book. You can see the data book also. So the figure shows the square thread. So the distance between the two threads midpoint is pitch P. Height of the thread is height H. So the distance between the thread is p by 2, pitch by 2. So height h is equal to 0.5 into p. So we can calculate the square thread. The pitch is taken as early as from standard dimensions. For example, the pitch is taken to 10 mm. So the distance between the two threads midpoint is 10 mm. So assuming the pitch is 10, so height of the thread is 0.5 into 10, that equals to 5 mm. This is the total height of the thread profile. So this is the thread profile. So the thread profile is mostly used for screw jacks and clamping devices and presses. So a thread profile is making by using the lathe with single point tool. So we created the thread profile, square thread profile, used to the lathe machine with a single point cutting tool is used to create the thread profile. Square thread profile. So next, ACME or traject, trapezoidal section. ACME or trapezoidal thread. An ACME or trapezoidal thread, as shown in the figure B, is a motivation of square thread. The slight slope given to its side lower the efficiency slightly than square thread, and it also introduces some bursting pressure on the nut, but increases its area in shear. It is used where a split nut is required and where provision is made to take up wear as the lead screws of the lathe. Wear may be taken up the means of an adjustable split nut. The ACME thread may be cut by means of dies, and hence it is more easily manufactured than square thread. So you can see the figure. So the distance between the thread midpoint is p. The angle between the thread between the distance is 29 degrees. The height of the thread is h, and distance between the single thread is 0.37 p. So here h is equal to 0.5 p plus 0.25 mm, same as like a square thread. So we can take in as the pitch is equal to p is 10 mm. So we can substitute in the value h equal to 0.5 into 10 plus 0.25. the height of the square thread is 5 plus 0.25. 5.25 is the total height of the thread. And width of the thread, single thread, is 0.37 into 10, that equal to 3.7. So is the width of the thread. So finally, the thread, the ACME thread, is making by means of dies. So by using the dies, the ACME thread is manufactured. So by compared to the square thread and ACME thread, so this is a very easy to manufacture. And compared to the square thread, ACME thread is manufactured easily by using the dies. So next type is buttress thread. A buttress thread, as shown in the figure here, you can see the figure, is also used when large forces act along the screw axis in one direction only. The thread combines the higher efficiency of the square thread and the case of cutting and the adaptability to split nut of ACME thread. It is stronger than the other threads because of greater thickness at the base of the thread. The buttress thread has limited use of power transmission. It is employed as the thread for light jack screw and vices. So you can see the figure. This is, you can see the figure is a buttress thread. So the distance between the thread threads midpoint is pitch p, and the distance between the single thread width of the thread is 0.125 into p. The angle between the thread is 45 degrees. The height is h, height of the thread is h. So therefore h is equal to 0.75 into p. This is the standard to standard values to calculate the threads, thread profiles, 0.75 p. So since we assume like a p is a 10 mm, so substitute in the value, so 0.75 into 10, that equals 7.5. The height of the p thread is 7.5. So width of the single thread is 0.125 into p, that equal to 1.25. So buttress thread is a large force acting on the screw jacks, which is only in one direction only. So compared to the both square thread and ACME or trapezoidal thread, so buttress thread is the most stronger than the other threads. So this is the why, because this is the greater thickness based on the threads. The buttress thread limited, it is used for the power transmission system. So the it employed as a thread as jack screws, light jack screws and vices used for the buttress threads. So these are the types of threads, so you can use it for the power screws. So next, multiple threads. The power screws with multiple threads such as double, triple, etc. are employed when it is desired to secure a large lead with fine thread or high efficiency. Such type of threads are used for in high speed actuators. So the multiple threads are used like this. So double or triple drive, we can use the threads are multiple threads. So it is desired to secure the large amount, large lead with fine thread or high efficiency. So this type of thread is used for high speed actuators. So next, torque required to raise load by square thread screws. So torque required to raise the load by square thread screws. The torque required to raise a load by means of a square thread screw may be determined by considering a screw jack. So as shown in the figure here, the load to be raised or load in place on the head of a square head rod, square thread head rod, when is rotated by the applications of an effort at the end of level for lifting or lowering the load. So by lifting or lowering the load, you can see the figure also. So a little consideration will shown that if one complete turn of the screw thread be imagined to be unwound from the body of the screw and develop, it will be formed an inclined plane as shown in the figure here. So you can see the figure. The torque required by means of the square thread determined considering a screw jack. So the square thread looks like we see this considering a screw jack to measure. So we can see the figure here. So this is the screw jack. So the dimensions of the parts of the screw jacks are nut, square threaded rod, level, head, pitch. So the distance between the two square threaded rod by between the two midpoints of the square threaded rod is pitch P, and weight is applied on the top of the head and lever. So lever is used to rotate the head by the square thread will be flows up and down. So the distance between DC small d and D naught is the distance between the inner diameter and outer diameter and middle diameter. So you can see the development of the screw. It looks like some triangular section. The distance between the height is P, angle is alpha, the length is pi d. So you can discuss it one by one. Let P is the pitch of the screw, so small d is the mean diameter of this screw. Alpha is equal to helix angle. P is equal to effort applied at a circumference of the screw to lift the load. Weight W is equal to load to be lifted and mu is equal to coefficient of friction between the screws and nut, that is equal to tan alpha, where alpha, sorry, tan phi, where phi is the frictional angle. So from the geometry of the figure here, we find that tan alpha is equal to P by pi d. So you can see the figure one. So tan alpha is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. So P by pi d. So this is the formula for the tan alpha is equal to P by pi d. Next, since the principle on which the screw jack works is similar to that an inclined plane, therefore the force applied on the circumference of the screw jack will be considered to be horizontal. So as shown in the figure, you can see the figure, this is a thrust coil. Since the load is being lifted, therefore the force of friction F is equal to mu Rn will act downwards. All the forces acting on a body, so as shown in the figure. So you can see the figure B, this is the force acting on a screw jack. So you can see the figure B in a horizontal thrusted collar. So the collar is in top of the head. In the bottom of the head is a square rod with the diameter is D. So R1 is the inner diameter and outer diameter. Next, the weight W is applied on the collar and the weight of the rod. The distance between the weight and collar thrust quad thread is R2. So you can see the figure B, while when load lifting is the friction of the force F is equal to mu R1. So F will be act as in downward. You can see the figure also, the Rn is act on the upward, the weight W is downward. So you can see the figure. So that this is the P cos alpha, the distance between alpha is P sin alpha. So you can draw the okay, triangular form. So the alpha is the angle with the distance of P, P sin alpha and P cos alpha, the weight W, you know, applying the downward. So this will also have W sin alpha and W cos alpha. So we can calculate in the derivation part the forces acting on this screw jack by applying the figure B. Resolving the forces along the plane, P cos alpha is equal to W sin alpha plus F equal to W sin alpha plus, you can substitute the value F is equal to mu Rn, equal to mu Rn. This is the equation number one. And the resolving the forces perpendicular to the plane, Rn is equal to P sin alpha plus W cos alpha. So the resolving forces perpendicular to the plane. So we can see the plane. What are the distance perpendicular to the plane is? The perpendicular distance, that is P sin alpha, this W cos alpha. This is note down the derivation. So Rn is equal to P sin alpha plus W cos alpha. Substituting this is the equation number two. Substituting the values of Rn in the equation we have P cos alpha is equal to W sin alpha plus mu. So substitute in the Rn value, so Rn is equal to P sin alpha plus W cos alpha, that is equal to W sin alpha is equal to mu P sin alpha plus mu W cos alpha, or P cos alpha minus mu P sin alpha is equal to W sin alpha plus mu W cos alpha. The common the P, when P is the common, P into cos alpha minus mu sin alpha, that equal to, when common the W equal to W into sin alpha plus mu cos alpha. Finally, therefore, P is equal to W into sin alpha plus mu cos alpha by cos alpha minus mu sin alpha. So this is the calculation part. So that we can calculate the power. P is equal to W into sin alpha plus mu cos alpha by cos alpha minus mu sin alpha. This problem This is used for the problems. So substituting the values of mu equal to tan alpha in the above expression, so we get, so we can substitute mu equal to tan alpha in the above equation, p is equal to w into sin alpha plus tan phi cos alpha by cos alpha minus tan phi sin alpha. So multiplying the numerator and denominator by cos alpha, sorry, cos phi. So we have p is equal to w into sin alpha cos phi into sin phi cos alpha by cos alpha cos phi minus sin alpha sin phi. That equal to w into sin alpha plus phi by cos alpha plus phi. So we can see the expression is sin a plus b. So what is the form of sin a plus b? Sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. So finally cos a plus b cos alpha cos beta minus sin alpha sin beta. So this is the derivation of the calculating the value, can calculate the derivation. So finally the b is equal to w into sin of alpha plus phi by cos of alpha plus phi. So sin by cos is equal to tan. So b is equal to w into tan of alpha plus phi. Therefore torque required to overcome friction between the screw and nut, so t1 is equal to p into d by 2, that is if substituting the value in p. So pw tan alpha plus phi into d by 2. So we can calculate the torque. The formula is used. So t1 is equal to w tan alpha plus phi into d by 2. So when the axial load is taken up the thrusted collar, so as shown in the figure B, so that the load does not rotate with the screw, when the torque required to overcome friction at the collar, so T2 is equal to 2 by 3 into mu 1 into W R1 cube minus R2 cube by R1 square minus R2 square. So assuming uniform pressure condition, that equal to mu 1 into W R1 plus R2 by 2, that equal to mu 1 W into R. So substitute, since capital R is equal to R1 plus R2 by 2, so we can substitute the value in the above equation. So we can replace the R1 plus R2 by 2 is R. So mu 1 into W into R. Where R1 and R2 is the outside and inside radius of collar. Capital R is the main radius of the collar is R1 plus R2 by 2. And mu 1 is the quotient of friction of the collar. So this is the derivation of torque required to raising load by screw threaded screw, so square threaded screw. So next, therefore the torque required to overcome friction, so overcome friction rotate of the screw, T capital T is equal to T1 plus T2. If an effect P1 is applied at the end of the level of arm length L, and the total torque required to overcome friction must be equal to the torque applied at the end of the level, that is T is equal to, so T1, substitute the value T1 is equal to P into D by 2, that is equal to P1 into L. Note, when the nominal diameter D0 and the core diameter DC of the screws is given, then mean diameter of the screw D is equal to D0 plus DC by 2, that is equal to D0 minus P by 2, that is equal to DC plus P by 2. Since the mechanical advantage is the ratio of the load lifted W to the effect applied P1 at the end of the level, therefore the mechanical advantage MA equal to So MM is mechanical advantage, that equal to W by P1, that is equal to W into 2L by P into D. Since P is equal to P into D by 2 equal to P1 into L, or P1 is equal to P into D by 2L. So substituting the value, so this formula you can see the top of the slide. P into D by 2 equal to P1 into L. So where P1 is equal to P into D by 2L. So substitute the values in below equation. Above equation, MA equal to W into P1. So W into 2L by P into D. So that equal to W into 2L by P. So what is the formula for the P is W tan alpha plus pi into D. That equal, we can cancel in the W, 2L is equal to D into tan alpha plus pi. So this is the mechanical advantage, the derivation of the torque required to raise the load on square threaded screw. So next, torque required to lower load by square threaded screw. So in last slide, we can see the torque required to riser. So riser load of this screw thread, square thread. So in this class will be, in this PPT you can see the square torque required to the lower load by square threaded screw. So this is the lower load. So how to apply the lower load? So first you can see the figure. So the figure is, the force will be in we can see the figure by see the figure in a rising load, the force will be downward, apply the force will be downward. So coming to the lower load, the force is applied to the upward. So you can see the figure also, the arrow mark of the force applied to the upward direction. A little consideration will show that when the load is being lowered, the force of friction F is equal to mu r1 will be act upwards. So all the forces acting on a body are shown in the figure. So you can see the figure also, the resulting the forces along the plane. The resulting forces along the plane, P cos alpha is equal to F minus W sin alpha. So you can see the figure. So resultant force, this is the resultant direction applied to the horizontal direction. So P cos alpha is equal to F force minus W sin alpha. You can see the diagram also. So substituting F is equal to mu r1, P cos alpha is equal to mu r1 minus W sin alpha. This is equation number one. So we can solve the perpendicular force. The perpendicular forces are P sin alpha, W cos alpha, and Rn. These three are perpendicular forces. Rn, P sin alpha, and P W cos alpha. So Rn is equal to W cos alpha minus P sin alpha. This is equation number 2. So substituting the values Rn in equation 1. So we have P cos alpha is equal to mu cos alpha, mu into W cos alpha minus P sin alpha minus W sin alpha. That is equal to mu into W cos alpha minus mu P sin alpha minus W sin alpha. P, mu P sin alpha is taken to the outside, or P cos alpha plus mu P sin alpha is equal to mu W cos alpha minus W sin alpha. When common to the P, so P into cos alpha plus mu sin alpha, and common the W into mu cos alpha minus sin alpha. Therefore, P is equal to W into mu cos alpha minus W, mu cos alpha minus sin alpha by cos alpha into mu sin alpha. So substituting the values of mu is equal to tan alpha in the above equation. So substituting the mu, see in tan alpha in above equation, P is equal to डब्ल्यू इंटू टैन आल्फा सॉरी टैन पाई कॉस आल्फा माइनस साइन आल्फा बाय कॉस आल्फा प्लस टैन पाई साइन आल्फा. सो मल्टीप्लाइंग अंडर न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर बाय कॉस आल्फा. सो वी हैव सो कॉस आल्फा मल्टीप्लाइंग द टर्म न्यूमरेटर अंडर डिनोमिनेटर इन द अबव इक्वेशन इन टैन पाई. Since the tan pi we can replace tan pi is equal to sin alpha by cos alpha. So by multiplying numerator and denominator in cos alpha by cancelling cos alpha in numerator and denominator. So p is equal to w into sin pi cos alpha minus cos alpha sin pi by cos pi cos alpha plus sin pi sin alpha. So this primary expression is given as w equal to P is equal to W into sin pi minus alpha by cos pi minus alpha. Okay, sin by cos is equal to tan. So P is equal to W tan alpha minus pi. So this is the derivation. You can calculate the power. The power P is equal to W tan alpha minus pi minus alpha. So this formula we can use it to solve the problems also. So therefore, torque required to overcome first frictional between the square screw and nut. T1 is equal to P into D by 2. So substituting the values, you can replace the P is W tan alpha pi minus alpha. So that equal to T1 is equal to W tan pi minus alpha into D by 2. Where alpha greater than pi, then P is equal to W tan alpha minus pi. Next, efficiency of square threaded screws. So what is efficiency of square threaded screws? The efficiency of square threaded screws may be defined as the ratio between the ideal effect, that is the effort required to move the load neglecting friction, to the actual effect, that is the effect required to move the load taking friction into account. We have seen in Act 17.4 that the effect applied at the circumference of the screw to lift the load is P is equal to W tan alpha plus pi. So this is the equation number one, where W is the load to be lifted. So alpha is helix angle. So pi is angle of friction and mu is the coefficient of friction between the screw and nut, that is equal to tan pi. If there would have been no friction between the screws and nut, then tan pi will be equal to zero. So the value of effect P naught necessary to raise the load will then be given the equation P naught is equal to W tan alpha. Substituting pi equal to 0 in equation 1. So P naught is equal to W tan alpha. So why am I using substituting the pi value is 0 in equation 1? That's why the P naught is equal to W tan alpha. Therefore, efficiency eta is equal to ideal effect by actual effect. So ideal effect P naught by P, that equal to W tan alpha by W tan alpha plus pi. So we can cancel the numerator and denominator in W, that is equal to tan alpha by tan alpha plus pi. This shows the efficiency of the screw jack is independent of the load raised. If the above expression for efficiency, only the screw jack friction is considered. However, if the screw jaw friction and collar friction is taken into account, then efficiency eta is equal to torque required to move the load neglecting friction by torque required to move the load include screw and collar friction, that is equal to T naught by T. So you can substitute the values T naught is equal to P naught into D by 2. In T is equal to P into D by 2 plus mu 1 W into R. So note, the efficiency may also be defined the ratio of mechanical advantage to the velocity ratio. We know that the mechanical advantage MA is equal to W into P1, that equal to W into 2L by P into T, that equal to W into 2L by W into tan alpha plus pi into T, that equal to 2L by D tan alpha plus pi, alpha plus pi. So you can refer article 17.4. and velocity ratio VR is equal to distance moved by the effect P1 in one revolution divided by distance moved by the load W in one revolution, that equal to 2 pi L by P, that equal to 2 pi L by tan alpha into pi D, that equal to 2, you can cancel this numerator and denominator in pi, so 2L by D tan alpha, since tan alpha is equal to P by pi D. So therefore final efficiency eta is equal to MA by VR, that equal to 2L by D D tan alpha plus pi into D tan alpha by 2L, that equal to, so you can cancel this in the 2L numerator and denominator and D also, tan alpha by tan alpha plus pi. So this is the shortcut model, you can calculate the efficiency. So next, maximum efficiency of a square threaded screw. So what is the maximum efficiency of a square threaded screw? So we have seen the article 17.6, the efficiency of a square threaded screw. So efficiency eta is equal to tan alpha by tan alpha plus pi. Since tan alpha is equal to substituting, tan alpha is equal to sin alpha by cos alpha, that is equal to substituting the value. So tan, we can replace the tan alpha is sin alpha by cos alpha by sin alpha plus pi by cos alpha plus pi, that is equal to sin alpha into cos alpha plus pi by cos alpha into sin alpha plus pi. So this is the equation number one. So multiplying the numerator and denominator by 2, we have efficiency eta is equal to 2 sin alpha plus cos alpha plus pi by 2 cos alpha into sin alpha plus pi, that is equal to sin 2 alpha plus pi minus sin pi by sin 2 alpha plus pi plus sin pi. So this is equation number 2. Since 2 sin a cos b equal to sin a plus b into sin a minus b, 2 cos a sin b equal to sin a plus b minus sin a minus b. So the efficiency is given, the equation 2 will be the maximum when sin 2 alpha plus pi is maximum, that is when sin 2 alpha plus pi minus 1 or when 2 alpha plus pi minus 90, therefore 2 alpha minus 2 alpha equal to 90 minus pi, or alpha is equal to 45 minus pi by 2. So substituting the value 2 alpha in equation 2, we have the maximum efficiency. So efficiency maximum eta max is equal to sin 90 minus pi plus pi minus sin pi divided by sin 90 degrees minus pi plus pi plus sin pi, that is equal to sin 90 minus sin pi by sin 90 plus sin pi. So sin 90 is equal to 1, so 1 minus sin pi by 1 plus sin pi. So this is the maximum efficiency of a square threaded screw. So next, problems on square threaded screw. A vertical screw with a single start square threaded of 50 mm main diameter and a 12.5 mm pitch is raised against the load of 10 kN. By means of a hand wheel, the boss of the boss of which is threaded to act as a nut, the axle load is taken up the truss collar which support the wheel boss and has a mean diameter of 60 mm. The coefficient of friction is 0.5, the square and 0.18 and the column. If the tangential force applied by each head to the wheel is 100 newton, so find the suitable diameter of the hand wheel. So this is the problem. We can note down the given data. The square thread diameter, mean diameter, small d is equal to 50 mm and pitch P is equal to 1.5 and weight W is equal to 10 kN. This will be converted to newton, 10 into 10 cube newton. Next, wheel, collar wheel, boss mean diameter capital D is equal to 60 mm or smaller is equal, capital R is equal to 30 mm. So smaller is equal, R is equal to D by 2, 60 by 2 equal to 30 mm. Quotient of friction mu is equal to tan alpha, that equal to 0.15. Mu 1 is equal to 0.18 for the collar. The pitch P1 is equal to 100 newton. So we know that the tan alpha is equal to P by pi d. P by pi d. That is the substitute values. P is equal to 12.5 pi into 50. That is equal to 0.08. So and the tangential force required at the circumference of this screw. So P is equal to W tan alpha plus pi is equal to W into tan alpha plus tan pi by 1 minus tan alpha tan pi. So tan pi, substituting the values, P is equal to W 10 into 10 cube into tan alpha 0.08 plus tan pi 0.15 by 1 minus 0.08 into 0.15. So we can calculating P is equal to 2328. Newton. So we also know that the total torque required to the turn the hand wheel, P is equal, T is equal to P into D by 2 plus mu 1 W into R. Substituting the values, P is equal to 2328 into diameter small d 50 by 2 plus mu 1 0.18 into capital W 10 into 10 cube into 30. That is equal to total torque T is equal to 58,200 plus 54,000. That is equal to 112,200 newton mm. So this is the equation number one. Let capital D1 is equal to diameter of the hand wheel in mm. So we know that the torque required to the hand wheel, so T is equal to 2P1 into capital D1 by 2. That is equal to 2 into 100 into capital D1 by 2, that is equal to 100 D1. So newton mm. So equation one, substitute, we can solve the equating 1 and 2. D1 is equal to 112,200 divided by 100, that is equal to 122 mm. So this will be converted to meters. So D1 is equal to 1.122 meter. So this is the problem. So next problem, an electric motor driven power screw moves a nut in a horizontal plane against a force of 75 kN at a speed of 300 millimeters per minute. The screw has a single wide thread of 6 mm pitch and a major diameter of 40 mm. The coefficient of friction at screw threaded is 0.1. So calculate, estimate the power of the motor. So the given data, W weight, W is equal to 75 kN. If that is equal to 75 into 10 cube newtons. So velocity, speed V is equal to 300. mm per minute. So major pitch diameter P is equal to 6 mm and major diameter D0 is equal to 40 mm and coefficient of friction mu is equal to tan alpha equal to 0.1. So we know that the mean diameter of this screw, that is D is equal to D0 minus P by 2. that equal to 40 minus 6 by 2, that equal to 6 by 2 is 3, 40 minus 3, 37 mm. So small d is equal to 37 mm. And tan alpha is equal to p by pi d. Substitute the value 6 by pi into 37, that equals 0.0516. So we know that the tangential force required the circumference of this group p is equal to w tan alpha plus pi, that equal to w tan alpha plus tan pi by 1 minus tan alpha tan pi. So substitute the values, w equal to 75 into 10 cube, 0.0516 plus 0.1 by 1 minus 0.0516 into 0.1. So we can calculate it. P is equal to 11.43 into 10 cube Newton. And the torque required to operate the screw, T is equal to P into D by 2, that equal to 11.43 into 10 cube into 37 by 2, that equal to 211.45 into 10 cube Newton mm. So this will be converted to Newton meter, 211.45 Newton meter. Since the screw moves in a nut at a speed of 300 millimeters per minute and the pitch of the screw is 6 mm, therefore the speed of the screw in revolutions per minute, so RPM, therefore n is equal to speed in mm per minute by pitch in mm, that is equal to 300 divided by 6, that is equal to 6530 and 650 is 300. So therefore n is equal to 50 RPM. And angular speed omega equal to 2 pi n by 60. So this is the standard formula. So 2 pi by 50 by 2 pi into n 50 by 60, that is equal to 5.24 radian per second. Therefore finally you can calculate the power of the motor. So the power of the motor equal to power p is equal to t into omega, 211.45 into 5.24, that is equal to 1108 watts. So this will be converted to kilowatts, 1.108 kilowatts. So next problem, the cutting of a broaching machine is pulled by a screw thread, wide threaded screw of small diameter 55 mm in the external diameter and 10 mm is pitch. The opening nut take the axle load 400 newton on a flat surface of 60 mm and 90 mm internal and external diameter respectively. That means of D1 and D2, capital D1 and capital D2 is given. If the coefficient of friction mu if tan alpha is given 0.15. For the contact surface of the nut, determine the power required to rotate the opening nut when the cutting speed is 6 meter per minute. So also the find the efficiency of the screw. So this is the given data. The given data is small d naught is 55 mm, pitch p is 10 mm, that equal to 0.01 meter, weight w is equal to 400 newton. So capital D1 exterior diameter, capital D2 is equal to 60 mm, or R2 is equal to 30 mm. So D1 internal diameter 90 mm, or R1 is equal to 45 mm. So mu equal to tan pi equal to mu 1, that equal to 0.15. So cutting speed is 6 meter per minute. So first you can calculate the power required to operate the nut. We know that the main diameter of this screw D is equal to D naught minus P by 2, that is equal to 55 minus 10 by 2, that is equal to 5. 55 minus 5 equal to 50 mm, so D is equal to 50 mm. Therefore tan alpha is equal to P by pi D, that is equal to 10 by 50 into pi. Tan alpha is equal to 0.0637. So the and force required at the circumference of the screw, P is equal to W tan alpha plus pi, that is equal to W into tan alpha plus tan pi by 1 minus tan alpha tan pi. Substituting the values, P is equal to W 400 into tan alpha 0.0637 plus tan pi 0.15 divided by 1 minus 0.067 into 0.15. So we can calculating power P is equal to 86.4 Newton. So we know that the mean radius of the flat surface R is equal to R1 plus R2 by 2, that is equal to 45 plus 30 by 2, that equal 37.5 mm. Therefore the torque required T, capital T, is equal to P into D by 2 plus mu 1 W R. Substituting the values, power P is equal to 86.4 into small d 50 by 2 plus mu 1 0.15 into capital W 400 into R 37.5. So we can calculate the values. T is equal to 4410 Newton millimeter. This will be converted to meters, that is equal to 4.41 Newton meter. So we know that the speed of the screw, N is equal to cutting speed by pitch. That is, cutting speed is already given, 6 by pitch equal to 0.01. This will be meter, that is equal to 600 RPM. So total speed of this screw is N is equal to 600 RPM. And angular speed omega equal to 2 pi n by 60, that is equal to 2 pi into 600 by 60, that is equal to 62.84 radian per second. Therefore the power required to operate the nut equal to T into omega, that equal to 4.41 into 62.84, that equal to 277 watts. So this will be converted to kilowatts, that equal to 0.277. next we can calculate the efficiency of this screw. So we know that the efficiency of this screw, eta is equal to T naught by T, that equal to W tan alpha into D by 2 by T. So substitute the values, W 400 into tan alpha 0.0637 into 50 by 2 by 4410. So that equal to 0.144. This will be converted to percentage. So eta equal to 14.4%. So next problem, a vertical two start square thread screw of 100 mm main diameter and 20 mm pitch support and a vital load and vital load of 18 kN. The axial thrust on a screw is taken by a collar bearing of 250 mm. And outside diameter is 100 mm, inside diameter. Find the force required at the end of the lever, which is 400 mm long. In order to lift the load, the coefficient of friction of a vertical screw nut is 0.15, and that the collar bearing is 0.20. So the given data, given small d is equal to 100 mm, so pitch P is equal to 20 mm, weight W is equal to 18 kN, that is equal to, this will be converted to Newton, 18 into 10 cube Newton, next is small capital D1 is equal to 250 mm, R1 is equal to 125 mm, D2 is equal to 100 mm, R2 is equal to 50 mm, L is equal to 400 mm, mu is equal to tan alpha, tan pi, that equal 0.15, mu 1 is equal to 0.20. So first you can calculate the force requirement at the end of the lever. Let P is equal to force required at the end of the lever. Since the screw is a two-started square threaded screw, therefore length of this screw is 2P, that equal to 2 into 20, 40 mm. So we know that tan alpha is equal to lead by pi D. So lead you can calculate 40 by pi into 100, that equal 0.127. So first we can calculate for raising the load. So we know that tangential force required at the circumference of this screw p is equal to w tan alpha plus pi, that is equal to w into tan alpha plus tan pi by 1 minus tan alpha tan pi. So you can substitute the values. P is equal to 18 into 10 cube into 0.127 plus 0.15 by 1 minus 0.127 into 0.15. That is equal to power p is equal to 5083 newton. And mean radius of the collar r is equal to r1 plus r2 by 2. That is equal to 125 plus 50 by 2, that is equal to 87.5 mm. Therefore, torque required at the end of the level, T is equal to P into 5 D by 2 plus mu 1 into W into R. So that is equal to, substitute in the values, 5083 into 100 by 2 plus 0.20 plus 18 into 10 cube into 87.5. So you can calculate in the value, torque T is equal to 569,150 newton millimeter. We know that the torque required at the end of the level T, 569,150 equal to P1 into L, that equal to P1 into 400, or P1 equal to 569,150 divided by 400, that equal to final looking calculating the P1 equal to 1423 newtons. So next we can calculate the force for lowering the load. So we know that the tangential force required the circumference of the screw, P is equal to W tan alpha minus pi, that equal to W into tan alpha minus tan pi by tan pi minus tan alpha by 1 plus tan alpha tan pi, that equal to 18 into 10 cube into 0.15 minus 0.127 divided by 1 plus 0.15 into 0.127. So you can calculate in the power P is equal to 406.3 newton. And the total torque required the end of the level, total torque T is equal to P into D by 2 plus mu 1 into W into R, that is equal to 406.3 into 100 by 2 plus 0.20 into 18 into 10 cube into 87.5, that is equal to 335,350 newton mm. So we know that the torque required at the end of the level T, that equal to 335,350 equal to P1 into L. So substitute in the value L is equal to 400, that equal to P1 into 400, or finally the P1 is equal to 335,315 by 400, that equal to P1 is equal to 8,838.3 newton. So this is the calculation for the lowering the end load for rising the load. So rising the load, the power P1 is equal to 423 newton. For lowering the load, P1 is equal to 838.3 newton. So next problem. So this is the last problem. You can calculate the power screw thread. Problems on square threads. The mean diameter of the square threaded screw having a pitch of 10 mm and 50 mm. The load 20 kN is lifted through a distance of 170 mm. So find the work done is lifted, the load and the efficiency of the screw. When the load rotates, then the screw and the load rests on the loose head which does not rotate with the screw. The external and internal diameter of the bearing surface of the loose head are 60 mm and 10 mm respectively. The coefficient of friction, of the screw and the bearing surface will taken as 0.08. So this is the problem. Next we can note down the given data. So given P equal to 10 mm, small d equal to 50 mm, W equal to 20 kN, that equal to 20 into 10 cube newton, D1 is capital D1 is equal to 60 mm, R2 is equal to capital R2 is equal to 30 mm. So R is equal to D by 2, substituting the D 60 by 2, that is equal to 30 mm. So small capital D2 is equal to 10 mm, R2 is equal to 5 mm. So mu is equal to tan pi is equal to mu 1 equal to 0.08. So we know that the tan alpha is equal to P by pi D, that equal to 10 by pi into 50, that equal to 0.0637. So therefore, we can calculate the force required at the circumference of the screw to lift the load. So P is equal to W tan alpha plus pi, that equal to W into tan alpha plus tan pi by 1 minus tan alpha tan pi. That is substituting the values, P is equal to W into 20 into 10 cube into 0.067 plus tan pi 0.08 divided by 1 minus tan alpha 0.0673 into tan pi 0.08. So we can calculating the values, so P power P is equal to 2890 newton. And the torque required to overcome friction at the screw, torque T is equal to P into D by 2. Power P is equal to 2890 into 50 by 2, that is equal to 72,250 Nm. So this will be converted to Newton meter, 72.25 Nm. Since the load is lifted through a vertical distance of 170 mm and the distance moved by the screw in one rotation is 10 mm equal to pitch, therefore the number of rotations made by the screw capital N is equal to 170 divided by 10, that equal to 17. So therefore N is the total number of rotations made by the screw. That total number of rotations is n equal to 17 rotations given, n equal to 17. When first we can calculate the when the load rotates with the screw, so we know that the work done is lifting the load capital T into pi into 2 into pi into n, that equal to 72.25 into 2 pi into 17, that equal to 7,718 Nm. And efficiency of the screw, eta is equal to tan alpha by tan alpha plus pi, that equal to tan alpha into 1 minus tan alpha tan pi by tan alpha plus tan pi. So substitute in the values, efficiency eta is equal to 0.0637 into 1 minus tan alpha 0.0637 into tan pi 0.08 divided by tan alpha 0.067 plus tan pi 0.08. So we can calculate efficiency eta is equal to 0.441 or 44.1%. So this is the load rotation in the screw. So next we can calculate the load does not rotate with the screw. So we know that mean radius of the bearing surface, so capital R is equal to R1 plus R2 by 2, that equal to 30 plus 5 by 2. So R1 not already given in the problem, capital D1 and D2, 30 plus 5, 35 by 2, that equal to 17.5 mm. Capital R is equal to 17.5 mm. And the torque required to overcome friction at the screw at the end of the collar, capital T is equal to P into D by 2 plus mu 1 into W into R. So substituting the values, that equal to 2890 into 50 by 2 plus 0.08 into 20 into 10 cube into 17.5. That finally we can calculate the value, that equal to 1,250 Nm. So this will be converted to Newton and meter, Newton meter. 100.25 Nm. Therefore, work done by the torque in lifting the load, T is equal to 2 pi n, that equal to 100.25 into 2 pi into 70, that is equal to 10,710 Newton meter. So we know that the torque required to lift the load neglecting friction, T naught is equal to P naught into D by 2. Since P naught is equal to W tan alpha, substituting the value is P naught. So W tan alpha into D by 2. So substituting the values, T naught is equal to W 20 into 10 cube into tan alpha 0.0637 into small d 50 by 2. That equal to, so we can calculating 31,850 Newton millimeter. So this will be converted to meter, 31.85 Newton meter. So therefore, finally we can calculate the efficiency of this screw. Efficiency eta is equal to T naught by T. That equal 31.85 divided by 100.25. That equal to 0.318 or 31.8%. So this is the final. You can calculate the problems of square threaded screws. So thank you.